Oh my God, we're back again. Brothers, sisters, everybody sing! If you get that reference, you get 10 points. If you get both of the references, technically, you get 20 points. There you go.
One, two, three, let's go!
So, except for my very bad American accent, sorry about that, I am here in the middle of April to do my March wrap-up. Because yeah, it happened again. So I've not been very well, which is why this wrap-up is happening in the middle of April instead of the beginning of April. So yeah, my usual plan is to have a wrap-up of the previous month and then the current month's TBR, like in the beginning of the month, not in the middle of the month, but here we go. Let's just get into the video, shall we? So, for the month of March, I read 6 books. Yeah, I kind of started the month off well, and then Instagram decided to put me in Insta jail, which just sort of put me off everything. Yeah, that happened. I read 6 books, I'm happy with that. Technically, 2 of them were rereads, so cheating? Nah. So let's start with the rereads. I read the 3rd book in the Mediator series, which is called Reunion by Med Cabot. As per usual, I won't be saying much about this, because that's for another time. Whichever, whenever that will be, but it'll happen one time and another. Media series, she speaks to ghosts. Sums it up, more or less. And the other reread I did was The Red Pyramid by Rick Riordan. This is Egyptian mythology, same style as the Percy Jackson ones. We'll talk about it later. So we got 4 books left. Let's see what we have. So the next book I read was The Great Cornish Getaway by Fern Britton. Now this is a quick reads book, so it's a short novellage book. And as soon as I started reading it, I was like, well, I'm missing something. So I looked it up. And apparently it's like a part of a series. So there's actual proper novels before this book, which kind of made more sense the further along in this novella I got. So the short gist of it is a Hollywood heartthrob shows up in this little village in Cornwall. And he sort of helps the villagers sort things out. I don't think it will be a spoiler to say that the Hollywood heartthrob is Richard Gere. Which made me question things, because this book came out in like 2017, 2018, something like that. And is Richard Gere still a Hollywood heartthrob? I mean, if this book came out in the 90s, I wouldn't have said much about it, but yeah, I don't know about that one. But basically, the character of Richard Gere has been in the previous novels as well, and I think there's like some after it. Don't quote me on that. I don't know. No, I don't know. But you know, other than the fact that it's like a short story, a part of several other novels, it was quick read. I did feel that I was missing information, and I presume this information comes in the novels, which I have not read, which I did not know about before picking this up. I picked this up because it was a quick read. I do like a quick read. They usually cost a pound. And they're very quick reads. They're like 100 pages. It's great. I mean, other than that, I did find it was, I mean, it was okay. It wasn't great. It was okay. It was readable, more or less. So next up we have We Own the Sky by Luke Allnut. So this book is about Rob and Anna and their relationship from start to building a family, and then about how do you cope with having a sick child. They go through several miscarriages and then they finally do have a child and he ends up being sick. So what I found with this one is that it's so depressing. I mean, it's a beautiful story of the love and all that and everything that comes with that, but it was so depressing. So it's not a book that I think I would actually pick up again, but I am happy that I did read it because, I mean, life isn't always a happy ending. So it's great to sometimes read fiction that's, you know, not a happy ending, because all fiction is not a happy ending. Everything is not a happy ending. So next up I have the first book in the Magpie Society, which is One for Sorrow by Zoe Sugg and Amy McCullough. So in short, is sort of a mystery book set in a boarding school environment. So we follow Audrey, which is the new girl arriving at this school, and Ivy, who's been there a long time. And neither can really stand the other, but then they're sort of forced together to kind of solve this mystery. I mean, I'm not sure they would actually have to solve this mystery, but they sort of take it upon themselves to find out what's going on. So the book starts off kind of slow, and then the middle is a bit meh, and the ending felt kind of rushed. The whole story kind of unfolds in a very weird pace. You'll get like a little crumb here and then nothing, and then like a big chunk and then nothing, and then a tiny little crumb again. So it never really felt like I got an understanding of where this story was heading. So the writing in it is very simplified, with random swear words added in here and there, which don't always make much sense, but there you go. So all in all, I think it might be a bit of a hit and a miss kind of a book. Will I continue with the series once the next book comes out? Probably. That's just me in a nutshell. But from having heard that it was kind of sort of like Broadchurch meets boarding school, I felt a bit disappointed, because I really liked Broadchurch. That was a great show. If you haven't watched that one, go watch it, because it's immense, especially the first series. The other one's a bit hit or miss, but first series, go watch it. But back to the book. I mean, having heard that it was mix of Broadchurch and boarding school, I did feel a bit disappointed in the book, because that was like aiming this high but only reaching about this high. I mean, it's fine, it's enjoyable enough, but yeah, at least it's pretty and the end papers are pretty. So as I said, it's part of a series. I don't know how many books there will be in this series, but I know there's at least one more. When that comes out, I don't know, but I shall keep an eye out. So to finish off this very bad wrap-up, I read The Evolution by Giovanna and Tom Fletcher. So this is the second book in the Eve of Man trilogy. So Eve of Man, let's go back to book number one in the series. So in Eve of Man is basically about Eve, who is the first girl born in 50 years, and she's grown up in a tower isolated from everyone, basically. And more or less, the whole point of her is that she will restart the evolution. She will restart having girls for the future, because they're just a lot of boys hanging around. Yeah, I don't think I'd like that. Too many boys. So, as I said, this is the second book in the series. So, this book takes off right where we left off in book number one, which is good, because the last thing we want from that ending was to have, like, a week's gap or something, or more. So, we just get thrown right into the middle of it. So, in book one, we have two perspectives. We had Bram and we had Eve. And in this one, there's a third one added. So this third character, Michael, did particularly like him. He's not a likable character, but I do see why he was added, because with his perspective, we get a whole new take on things going on, and it definitely adds to the story as a whole. However, this book is definitely a middle book. Although a lot happens in this book, it's a lot slower paced than the first one. And of course, we end on another cliffhanger, because why not? And we just have to wait a whole nother year for the third book to come out, which I have pre-ordered, so that will be fun. So yeah, that is my terrible wrap-up of the books I read in March. Please forgive me. I'm sorry. So as always, please remember to like, comment and subscribe, because it really helps me out. So until next time, take care and bye-bye. The short gist of it is a Hollywood heartthrob. I can't say that word.